Hey guys, Dylan here with Motion VFX, and I am stoked today because we're going to go over 5 really helpful tools that we put into MTuber 3 to help you grow your channel. We're going to jump right into it. I know your time is valuable. Tool number 1, our intros. We created 7 unique intros to help you solidify your channel's brand and show your viewers what your channel's all about. We made them easy and really simple to use. Just drag and drop the intro over your footage and we'll make some adjustments. Let's say I have a gaming channel and my channel colors are gold, white, and black. We'll open up our inspector window. Let's scroll down to the bottom first. Find those triangles and let's adjust the colors to fit our channel. Now, if you scroll up, you'll see we have an option to type in our channel name or put our channel icon in the animation by using the drop zone, finding the media we want to use in our library, and clicking apply. We'll also adjust our second text. And to move the text, it's as simple as just dragging the text on your screen where you'd like. You can move the entire thing just by moving your on-screen controls here, and even make it larger by expanding this circle. That's it. Simple, easy to use, and personalized. These intros also give you a cool little transition from your shots. The second helpful tool is our all-new chapter bars. Now you can give your audience a way to quickly see what is covered in your video. Professional looking visuals like these not only look good, but they also provide a benefit to your viewers, and that is one surefire way to get them to subscribe. Like everything in the pack, they are also really easy to use. Just drag and drop one of the 5 options to choose from above your timeline after you have finished your edit and stretch it out so it is the full length of your video. Have the preset start on the first frame and end on the last. First, you'll decide how many chapter markers you'll need. This tutorial I created is about 8 problems in Final Cut Pro, so I know I'll need 8 markers and 2 more for an intro and outro, so 10 total. This parameter right here will allow you to choose the amount of markers that show up on the line. Now let's scrub through our timeline to start dragging our chapter markers to their correct location. You want to find the points on your timeline where you'd want the start of a new chapter or section to be. I'll put the first marker at the beginning because that's the intro. Right here is where the first chapter of the tutorial should go because I talk about my first point. You'll just drag the marker to where the end of the moving chapter progress line is. Then head to your inspector and type in your custom chapter name for that marker in the inspector window. And then find the next point. Move the chapter marker and type in the chapter name. If you need to, you can give yourself a little room just by sliding these chapter markers down a little. The third tool is our zoom and select tools. We give you tons of different options to highlight key points in your video with tools like dash selection, pointer, and indicator, which gives an easy to adjust text box. So easy, in fact, that when you type in what you want to say, the text box changes in size with what you're writing. No more having to adjust the size of the text box to fit the text. An issue I personally have with Final Cut is the lack of ease in and ease out scaling features. Luckily, the zoom tool in the pack can help with that. Just drag it over your footage, adjust the location of the zoom by using your on-screen controls, adjust the amount of the zoom with the camera's Z position, and now you quickly have a smooth-looking zoom in and zoom out of whatever part of your video you'd like. Don't click off just yet, we have 2 more tools that can really help to grow your channel. The 4th set of tools are our new and improved call to actions. Want to highlight something a subscriber has said on your channel? We have something for that. Want more than one option to tell people to subscribe? Definitely got you covered. My personal favorite is this call to action, which not only hints to your subscriber to press the subscribe button, but it also has your channel name and icon, as well as a personalized message that you can quickly type in. Everything on this is easily customizable. You can move and adjust it easily by using the on-screen controls. You can change the text and color on everything in your inspector window. Last tool we'll go over today, we created a dozen titles that are not only simple to use, but they also have a minimalistic style to them. Titles and packs can sometimes be a little bit too flashy in my opinion, so the titles we created focus on letting you get your point across simply and beautifully with smooth animations. We have some cool options for lower thirds for names, titles to display your channel name like this one, some great options for quotes and chapter titles, even titles that could work as a call to action. Sometimes saying like and subscribe can feel like it detracts from the point of your video. I know that's the case for me with videos on my personal channel. This title can give you an option to get that much needed like and subscribe message across while you're talking about what you want to be talking about in your videos. And obviously, these are fully customizable, so write whatever you want in there. If you're looking to create better videos faster, MTuber 3 can really help out. Head on over to the Motion VFX website to check out the plugin fully, and make sure to subscribe if you have not already. We have a lot of cool plugins in the works, and this channel is one way to get notified about them. Once again, my name is Dylan, and I will see you in the next one.